In today's video, I am going to explain relationship between kidney and low back pain. This is kidney. Kidney is very deep organ inside of abdomen. It is highly related to low back pain. I'm going to focus on two aspects. In first part, I'm going to explain relationship with muscles. And on second part, I'm going to explain relationship with nervous tissue. There are two kidneys in human body. Again, they are so deep inside. I'm going to explain four muscles. First muscle is this one. This is psoas. Psoas is hip muscle. Psoas and kidney are so close each other. Actually, they are facing each other. Yep, they are so close. What happens if somebody has kidney dysfunction or somebody has tight psoas? They may affect each other. Tight psoas may affect kidney. Kidney dysfunction may affect psoas. So it is like an yin-yang relationship. If one of them gets tight, the other one is affected. This is so important. First muscle is psoas. Next one is, this pink one is quadratus lumborum. Quadratus lumborum. This is also close to kidney. It is hidden by psoas. Quadratus lumborum is like this. You know, quadratus means rectangular shape. Thus, in reality, quadratus lumborum shapes like this. It is also close to kidney. They are facing each other like psoas. Plus, psoas and quadratus lumborum are also close each other. Like psoas, when quadratus lumborum gets tight, that may affect kidney. When kidney got dysfunction, that may affect for quadratus lumborum. Tendency is that psoas and quadratus lumborum tend to get tight together because they are literally close each other. These relationships are so important to understand low back pain. Well, I explained two muscles. Let me explain other two muscles. Next one is this muscle. This is so important for breathing. This is, of course, diaphragm. Diaphragm, particularly this part. This is crura. Crura of diaphragm. Crura means leg. So crura looks like leg of diaphragm, right? Crura is also close to kidney. And lower part of diaphragm is also close to kidney. Basically, kidney is close to lower part of diaphragm. So it's like psoas and quadratus lumborum. Kidney and diaphragm have a relationship with each other. When kidney got dysfunction, that affects diaphragm. When diaphragm got dysfunction, that affects for kidney. Simple, right? Knowing this kind of relationship is so important for your clinical experience. Anyway, diaphragm, crura, and kidney. The last muscle, but you don't see the last one. Imagine there is like a corset-like abdominal muscle. That is transverse abdominis. Transverse abdominis. This is very deep abdominal muscle and it's very thin muscle. Transverse abdominis also, of course, has relationship with kidney. I don't need to say, but I will say that just in case. When transverse abdominis gets dysfunction, that affects kidney. When kidney got dysfunction, that may affect four transverse abdominis. I explained four muscles in first part. Psoas, quadratus lumborum, diaphragm, and transverse abdominis. These four muscles are important for stabilization of core and, of course, for breathing. Thus, you may be able to say kidney dysfunction may affect for core stability and breathing. Okay, this is so important relationship. Now for next part, let me explain relationship with nervous tissue. Okay, this is posterior view. This is kidney. Now, there are a bunch of nervous tissues from lumbar spines. Again, kidney is on deep part. These nervous tissues emerge from spines. Spines are located on posterior part, very deep part. Thus, these nervous tissues are close to kidney, particularly on upper lumbar spines. They are literally close each other. Kidney and nervous tissues are facing each other. Okay, when kidney get dysfunction, that may affect for nervous tissue, particularly from upper lumbar spines. But tightness of kidney may affect for whole nervous tissues from lumbar spines. How come? Because these nervous tissues are kind of bundle. It forms like bundle of nerves. This bundle is called lumbar plexus. Lumbar plexus. They are not singular. They are plural. Thus, when one part gets tension from kidney, this tension can go to rest of the nerves because they are bundles. It's not singular formation. They are plural. They are mass of nervous tissues. When one part gets tension, this tension can go to other nervous tissues. It's so important, right? Then kidney can be tied from trauma around upper low back. How come? Let me explain its landmark. Okay, there are a bunch of muscles. It's hard to see. Kidney is about here. This is right kidney. There is important anatomical landmark. This is 12th rib. The last rib. 12th rib. And this is erector spinae. Erector spinae, this is back muscle. Again, this is edge of erector spinae. This is 12th rib. In between these two structures, there is space about here. It's about this space. There is not much thick muscle at this pink area. Okay, there's no erector spinae, there's no thick muscle. So when you get heavy trauma, strong impact around this area, that may hurt kidney, because kidney is on deep part of abdomen. It's rather close to back. And this part is very thin, very fragile. What happens if you fall on backward and hit here? That may create trauma for kidney. Then, what's there? What kind of tissues are around kidney? Muscles and nervous tissues. Thus, trauma around upper back, particularly between 12th rib and edge of erector spinae. This trauma can give huge effect for nervous tissues, muscle tissues, and for kidney. That is why kidney is highly related for low back pain. In today's video, I explained relationship between kidney and low back pain. I explained from two different aspects. The one was muscle tissue. The second one was nervous tissues. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.